Welcome to Lubricant Formulation 101, How to Choose the Right Viscosity Index Improver. Viscosity, which measures a fluid's resistance to flow, is a crucial characteristic of a lubricant. The higher the viscosity of the lubricant, the greater the force required to move one surface relative to another. A lubricant that is too thin for an application, meaning its viscosity is too low, will not create a thick enough film to separate surfaces. A lubricant that is too thick, meaning its viscosity is too high, will put added stress on equipment. Both scenarios can lead to premature wear, damage, and equipment failure. This is why pinpointing and maintaining a specific viscosity is critical for machinery and equipment to run smoothly. Temperature significantly impacts viscosity. As temperature rises, lubricants become less viscous or thinner. As temperatures fall, lubricants become more viscous or thicker. Consider honey as a comparison. When heated, honey becomes thinner and flows more easily. In cold conditions, however, honey becomes thick and more solidified. Lubricating oils behave similarly under different operating temperatures. To evaluate the base oil quality, formulators and engineers use the viscosity index, which measures the rate of change in viscosity with temperature. The higher the VI, the less the base oil's viscosity changes. However, in many applications, high VI base oils are insufficient. For this reason, viscosity index improvers are used in many lubricant formulations exposed to different operating temperatures, such as engine oils, hydraulic fluids, and transmission oils. Viscosity index improvers, also called viscosity modifiers, are polymers that help maintain viscosity over wide temperature ranges to ensure consistent flow and lubrication. Several different viscosity index improvers are available to formulators. Common chemistries used in lubricants include olefin copolymers, polymethacrylates, and styrene-butadiene copolymers. These polymers expand at higher temperatures to increase the viscosity and contract at lower temperatures so fluids flow more easily. Now that we have reviewed viscosity, viscosity index, and why viscosity index improvers are used, how do you decide on the right additive for your formulation? Important factors to consider are the viscosity requirements, compatibility, and performance properties. First, determine the viscosity range needed for your application and select a viscosity index improver that can effectively maintain the viscosity of the lubricant within that range. Consider the temperature variations and operating conditions the lubricant will experience. Secondly, ensure that the viscosity index improver is compatible with the base oil and other additives in the formulation. Compatibility is critical to prevent separation or destabilization of the lubricant and regulate its performance over time. Lastly, evaluate the performance characteristics of the viscosity index improver. These include its shear stability and resistance to thermal degradation. Engine oils are changed regularly and generally do not require a viscosity index improver with high shear stability. Alternatively, shear stability is critical in transmission oil applications, as these lubricants have much longer lifespans. The shear stability index is a measurement used to indicate the shear stability of a polymer. Choose a viscosity modifier that offers the desired performance. By carefully choosing the right viscosity index improver for your lubricant formulation, you can ensure consistent performance under varying temperatures. The additive manufacturer or a lubricant technical specialist can help you determine whether a viscosity index improver is suitable for your application. At ChemPoint, we strive to connect lubricant formulation materials with the customers who need them. Lubricant technical specialists are available to assist you with your formulation questions. Contact us today to speak with a technical representative.